How do I start a business if I have a full-time job? I get this question a lot. It's a great question. It deserves some thought. Here are some thoughts that I have about starting a business if you have a full-time job. And it's actually something that I wish I would have told myself when I was 26, 27, 28 years old, and ultimately at 28, I left my job to start my own business. But I would have done things a lot differently, I think, in those 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years that I was working for somebody else, to really set myself up for that transition to be easier. And here's what I mean by that. The first thing I would say is take a look, a hard look, an honest look at your expenses. And what that means is look and see what you are spending money on, and if you actually need to be spending money on those things, or if you're just spending money on those things because you have the money. It's a funny thing that happens when you get money. You start, the more you make, the more you spend, and you're spending it on stuff just to spend it on stuff. I see it all the time with friends and clients. So first thing is take a hard look at your balance sheet, take a hard look at your expenses, take a hard look at your credit card statement and say, I can cut this, I can cut this, I can cut this. And then what you wanna do is you wanna boil it down and have a number that you need to make every single month. So you know I can live in the lifestyle that I want. It's up to you. I don't know what that looks like for you. For me, it was really, really low because I'm extremely frugal and the business just mattered more to me than the stuff. And so, that's that first thing. Get your number down. The second thing is take a look at your bank account. How much money do you have in your bank account? So if you're gonna spend $5,000 a month and you have $5,000 in your bank account, that's not very good. It's not a very long what I call runway. And a runway is basically like I have $60,000 in my bank account, which means if I'm spending $5K a month, I'm good for a year even if I don't make money. And that matters when you're trying to think about the transition. So now you know what you're spending on, now you know how much you need, now you know how much you have, now what do you do? Well, if you have a somewhere between a 9 to let's say 18 month runway, then I think that you can probably make a business happen. And it might not be the business that you're imagining, the business of your dreams, but it's a business that will sort of get you flowing and get you in that momentum to have the business that you want. You can start to make money in 6, 8, 9, 12 months. So that takes me to these two basic scenarios. Scenario number one is I hate my job. If you hate your job and you have that 6 to 12 month to 18 month runway, I'd say you're probably in a pretty decent chance spot to get out of that job and start building what you want. If you're like, I actually like my job and I love my job, then I would really spend time looking at the things that you like and love about your job and seeing if there is anything. And as a matter of fact, in both situations, I would say, see if there's anything in the job that you love or the job that's okay or the job that you hate. If there's anything that you can do to build on those skill sets or on that job description that will help propel you into the job you want. For example, I work at a bank, I hate it. I hate the bank, but I have access to 100 different colleagues. What I really wanna do is teach yoga. Well, look at your bank friends, your bank colleagues, your bank coworkers as potential clients. Start offering free yoga, start offering free retreats, start offering free advice, free nutrition plans, free whatever. And all of a sudden, if you do that for 6 to 12 months while you're saving that money, you have that stable paycheck, by the time you're ready to take that leap, you might already have 10, 15, 20 clients just from the people that you know. If you have something, a job that you love or that you like, then think about what is it that I love about this job, that I like about this job, and how can I use that experience to propel me into something further. So for example, if I was smart, my last job when I was doing speech writing for Mayor Bloomberg's administration, and the commissioner that I worked for was oftentimes way too busy to give the speeches that he was invited to give, I would have learned everything that I could have about the company because I liked the work, I liked my boss, I liked the nature of taking information and turning it into a story and then conveying that story to the public. I would have told my boss that, listen, let me go in your place. I know you're too busy. And then what I would have done is I would have started to make a name for myself as a speaker in that current role. And I think it would have been a lot easier for me to transition into a full-time speaking career if I would have done that during my job. So I think these are really important things to think about. And then in all situations, hate my job, like my job, don't care about my job, love my job, but want to start my own business, there are so many hours in the day. I would say take a hard audit, look at exactly how you're spending every single minute of your day, and what you'll find, and I can guarantee you, is that you think that you're being more productive than you're actually being. There are a lot more minutes and hours in the day than you think. So stop watching television, stop hanging out at happy hour, stop going to early dinners, do the things that you want to be doing in the time that you have. If you have an hour ride on the subway to work and then an hour ride on the subway home from work, that's two extra hours that you have every day to be dreaming about what you want to be doing, to make action items, write that book, record that book into your audio, read that, listen to that book, watch that YouTube video, whatever you need to be doing to actually move that dream forward, that is the time. I promise you, you have way more time than you think if you actually audit every minute, every hour, every day of your week. And at the end of that audit, you're gonna see, oh my God, I actually spent 3 hours tonight watching TV. I spent 2 hours today talking on the phone with a friend that I actually had nothing to talk about. Think about how you're spending the time. Use every single second towards building that side business. And eventually that side business can become your full business. And you can then decide, do I wanna leave my job? Do I wanna stay at my job? But at least you have that decision to make. So I hope this was helpful. It is completely 100% possible to start your full-time business, even if you have a full-time job. Hope these are some tips that will help you get there. If you like this, lots more, subscribe. Thank you for your attention. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.